Hello students, today I am going to teach you how to balance chemical equations if what equations are given. So this is the what equation. Iron combines with chlorine to give iron 3 chloride. Now here let me remind you one thing that iron has two variable valences 2 and 3. So here the Roman letter 3 indicates that its valency is 3. So the symbol of iron is Fe. Chlorine, the formula of chlorine is Cl2 and the formula for iron 3 chloride is FeCl3. As when elements combine, they interchange their valencies. Okay. So, now you see on the reactant side, iron is 1, product side also 1. Now, always remember, whenever you balance chemical equation, you are going to start with metals, non-metals and then oxygen and hydrogen at the end. Okay. So, then chlorine, this side it is 2, product side it is 3. So, in order to equalize, we need to multiply by 3. 2, 3 is 6. And this side by 2. Then it becomes 6. That means, here we need to multiply by 3. Okay. 3 2 is 6. On the other side, Cl3. So, in order to equalize, we need to multiply by 2. But, what do we see? If we multiply FeCl3 by 2, iron also becomes 2. So, what we do is that, we multiply Fe also by 2. Okay? And after balancing the equation, we can put the sign of equality because according to the law of conservation of mass, atoms can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. Okay? Hence, the law of conservation of mass is followed. Now, let us come to the next example. Magnesium reacts with dilute sulfuric acid to give magnesium sulfate and hydrogen. So, what will be the chemical equation? Symbol of magnesium Mg. Formula of sulfuric acid H2SO4. Formula of magnesium sulfate MgSO4. And formula of hydrogen is H2. So, magnesium reactant side 1, product side 1. Hydrogen also reactant side 2, product side 2. Sulfur reactant side 1, product side 1. Oxygen reactant side 4, product side also 4. So the equation is already balanced. So what we'll do, we'll just remove the sign of arrow and write the sign of equality. Okay, so you can put the sign of equality only after balancing the chemical equation. Now, let's move to the next example, and that is when magnesium reacts with oxygen to give magnesium oxide. Now, here you see magnesium again Mg, oxygen is O2, magnesium oxide formula is MgO. So, reactant side 1 magnesium, product side also 1 magnesium, reactant side 2 oxygen, product side 1. So, what we need to do is that we need to multiply it by 2 in order to make it 2. Okay. So, we will, in order to make this oxygen atom on the product side 2, we need to multiply MgO by 2. But, when we multiply MgO by 2, magnesium also becomes 2. So, on the reactant side also, we need to multiply magnesium by 2. Okay, so the balanced chemical equation will be 2Mg plus O2. Then you can put the sign of equality, it gives 2MgO. Okay, now let us move to the next one, and that is calcium oxide plus water gives calcium hydroxide. So, you can see reactant side calcium number of atom is 1, oxygen it is 1 plus 1, 2, hydrogen it is 2. Product side, calcium is 1, oxygen is 2, hydrogen is also 2. Always remember this for radicals, okay, the subscript stands for all the atoms which are inside the bracket. Now, calcium is already 1, oxygen already 2, hydrogen also 2. So, the equation is already balanced. So, what we will do is that we will simply remove the sign of arrow and write the sign of equality. Okay. Then, let's come to the next example. Sodium reacts with chlorine to give sodium chloride. Okay. So, reactant side, sodium is 1, chlorine is 2. Product side, sodium is 1, chlorine is also 1. So, sodium is balanced. But what about chlorine? In order to make it equal, what we need to do is that we need to multiply chlorine by 2 so that it becomes 2. So, in order to do that, we need to multiply NaCl by 2. But in that case, what happens? Sodium also becomes 2. So, what do? We multiply sodium by 2 in order to balance it. And hence, we can write the sign of equality. So, in this way, practice balancing the chemical equations. Thank you.